Let's take a look at Bolin's skills, breaking it up into two separate skill trees, the bending tree and the non-bending tree.
It's Bolin time.
All right, Bolin time. Bolin time!
We'll start with the bending tree and his most obvious skill on it, traditional earthbending. The base for all of his bending, his knowledge and aptitude when it came to classic earthbending techniques was apparent from the very beginning. Bolin had no problem planting himself like a rock, delivering some stubbornly powerful blows. But his first skill on the non-bending tree was actually in direct contrast to the traditional style of earthbenders. That was his ability to be light on his feet. Up until we met Bolin, most earthbenders we had seen before had one thing in common. They were partial to being rigid and strong in their stance and fighting style. The closest thing we saw to breaking away from this philosophy were the techniques of the Dai Li. But their departure was nothing compared to how far Bolin strayed from his earthbending roots, adopting a bouncier style reminiscent of a professional boxer. Which brings us back to the bending tree, where that technique led to his alternative bending style. That's right, Bolin incorporated this unprecedented airbender-like lightness into his earthbending. While it seems as though earthbending requires one to plant themselves firmly,
the key to earthbending is your stance. You've got to be steady and strong. Rock is a stubborn element. If you're going to move it, you've got to be like a rock yourself.
Bolin didn't let that stop him from using his light-footed techniques.
But in a real match, you'd be a sitting turtle duck. Not so upright and flat-footed. Stay light on your toes, right up until the moment when you need to dig in and strike, then pop pop!
Learning to switch between light and heavy stances on a dime when necessary. This not only enhanced his bending, but also his agility in battle, allowing him to fight with powerful earthbending while still performing swift and acrobatic maneuvers that always kept his opponents guessing. That style is what made him such a good athlete. And the perfect candidate for a pro bending team. Able to dodge and weave while still being offensive with his bending, Bolin was an essential part of the Fire Ferrets roster.
Bolin goes in for the grapple. Chang reverses. Another strike from Bolin, and Chang's in the drink.
The Future Industries Fire Ferrets win their quarterfinal match.
It was in this arena that he first proved his next non-bending skill, resilience to pain.
And Bolin takes a zinger to the shoulder. Looks like it's a clean hit.
Oh! Bolin!
Knuckles in the drink and out of the match. And Bolin keeps playing with one good arm. I gotta hand it to him, this kid's got grit.
While this was very useful in his pro bending matches, it proved to be quintessential in more dangerous situations, like real battles, where his ability to continue fighting could mean the difference between life and death. Next on the bending tree is another thing that we don't see too often when it comes to earthbending. That's his fine control. While many earthbending techniques rely on area of effect type damage, Bolin proved time and time again that he is an expert in fine precision, even able to fire a tiny pebble directly into Pali's third eye from a distance.
Bolin, take the shot! Haha, nice job, little bro!
Moving back over to the non-bending tree, let's take a look at his vehicle versatility. Throughout the series, we see that Bolin doesn't need to be grounded to fight. he's proven himself a sufficient fighter on a number of vehicles. From cars...
Bolin, give me a ramp! Now!
Whoa! To airplanes. And even on Naga's back.
Mr. Sato, you are a horrible father!
Perhaps his rarest bending skill, and the one you've all probably been waiting for, is his ability to lava bend. And it's not only the skill itself that's impressive, but how he discovered it.
Bolin!
Finding the ability within himself with no prior training, proving that Bolin can accomplish great things in the heat of the moment. No pun intended.
You're a lava bender.
I know. I just found out.
One trait Bolin has an abundance of, which seems to be underrated or overlooked, is his charisma. His humor and kindness leads him to be a great person to hang out with. And even helped him get noticed and become a very popular mover star.
Looks like you forgot that water and automatons don't mix.
Beep, bop, boo. Oh no, circuit's not working.
We did it!
Finally, his last bending skill is advanced lava bending. Just a few years after discovering his ability, he had developed it beyond just a simple state change. He was now able to shape the lava and apply his precision to create a dangerous threat to enemies. Learning to use more fluid movements reminiscent of waterbending brought his ability to adapt traditional earthbending techniques full circle. But among all of these amazing skills and abilities, maybe his most important one is his ability to do the thing.
Bolin, do the thing!
Well, at first he struggled to grasp the concept of the thing.
What thing?
The thing! I never had to tell Zhu Li what thing!
After vigorous training with Thing Master Varric, Bolin perfectly executed the thing.
Ah, yes! You did it, Bolin! You did the thing!
Showing off his ability to do the thing like he's never done the thing before. Okay, just kidding. His final and most important skill is loyalty. That's to say that Bolin is a fiercely loyal friend.
I came by to give you my sincere, heartfelt words of encouragement. I know our lives have been moving in two different directions, but I want you to know that I will always be there for you.
Always willing to put himself in danger to stand up for those he cares about.
Thanks. You didn't have to come back.
Yeah, I kinda did. Let's go.
Even when he found himself on the wrong side, unintentionally hurting those he loved.
I'm glad you're okay, but it's a little late for sorry.
I know, I didn't listen to you, and I sided with Kuvira, and I helped her take over the Earth Kingdom and topple your home and get your mom captured and your brothers and your dad. Wow, that does sound really bad when I say it out loud like that.
He did whatever he could to make these things right.
Perfect! You're all here!
Bolin?
What are you doing here? Guards, remove these traitors!
No! We escaped Kuvira's army! We're back on your side now! We have top secret information for you!
Okay, I guess we should open with that line.
Listen to me. Kuvira's making this thing that goes ba-boo! Ah! I don't know how it works, but it has this...
It's a super weapon. Like a regular weapon, only super.
And in the end, it became clear that friendship was the most important part of his life.
And he wasn't alone. He had his friends to help him. Look, the arena might be shut down, but we're still a team. The new Team Avatar.
And there you have it, Bolin's completed skill tree. If there are any skills we missed that you'd like to see, let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to do the thing.